The United States government will implement temporary measures to increase our abilities to detect and contain the coronavirus proactively and aggressively.
At the beginning of March, we started hearing reports, mostly from Asia.
Asia Pacific, Europe,
Latin America,
North America.
People are starting to show up with cases.
And then it just went.
We are watching it sort of march its way around the globe.
It was a surprise to us how quickly it became a global problem.
It became pretty obvious that the primary goal is development of new tests.
We were getting inundated with labs trying to start up, trying to understand what to do and how to get going.
As a lab, we did not have a dedicated COVID-19 test. We had to pivot our business almost completely.
Resources were very tight initially. We did multi-sourcing to try to keep up with all the demand.
We knew that this is going to be one of the largest situations that we've ever dealt with.
Mr. President, thank you, and thank the administration for all of the collaboration to enable Thermo Fisher Scientific to be able to produce the test kits that companies like LabCorp and Quest and the public health labs around the world run.
When Mark Casper was at the White House, the commitment at the time was that we would deliver 10 million tests per week.
But how do we get from something where we would typically sell 300 or 400 kits that would test 1,000 people in each a week to 10 million a week? That's a massive, massive difference in scale.
We say per week, we didn't even have that as a really a denomination of measurement.
They don't have the infrastructure or the manpower to be able to handle that kind of a volume with the push of a button.
It's not just a matter of throwing labor at these problems. The scale-up effort takes a lot more time, and you have to get a lot more creative on that side.
You rely on suppliers, and those suppliers have suppliers. That entire supply chain was just not ever built to produce what the kind of quantities that the pandemic is requiring.
On the other side, we have to also build all the instruments that do this testing. We can run our tools and our processes 24 hours a day, which is what we're doing in a lot of cases, but there's a fixed capacity there.
A lot of high priorities right now, keeping the site open and running, assist the manufacturing team in any way, working with customers around the world, working with the government to help set up high throughput labs.
If we don't do it right, the world's not gonna get better.
Is there much difference between your test and the Roche test?
There's only one competitor out there, and that's the virus. And right. The more tests available for the public, Jim, is really what the important thing is.
We fast-track everything.
We quickly pivoted to what does our supply chain look like. We have worked with suppliers that we've never worked with before.
Everyone's really kind of doing things outside of their day job.
I volunteered to help with the manufacturing site. We've done packaging, filling.
It soon became really apparent that we had to go to 3 shifts. So we went to 24-hour operation 7 days a week.
Normally processes that take like 6 weeks, we're making it happen within a day or two.
The volume of manufacturing is about 5 times the volume we were at the beginning of March.
Your normal day-to-day schedule, just it looks so different, and you're okay with that.
I have pushed my team to take a day off, and I can't get them to do it. It kind of turns into, well, you first.
A lot of people are depending on us, and so we're trying to move fast, but yet keep safe.
The current situation has brought out the very best in a lot of people, and that's been impressive to see.
Knowing that we're making a difference in the world right now is the positive thing about it.
We are proud to work in a company that is part of the solution on this whole situation.
We initially had the capacity to do about 1,000 COVID-19 tests per day. Today, we're at about 25,000 tests that we can run.
We've had some videos of the nursing home patients that, you know, finally got to go outside because they got tested and they're all negative and they're outside in the sun in Seattle and they're all, you know, they're dancing.
We're not done yet. And we haven't given up, and we haven't, you know, stopped. And we're going to continue to pursue this until it's over.
I believe that the experience we're going through now will change our world forever.
This customer called him and said, well, you don't know how many lives you're going to save. So.